crowns grow as a result of this combination of underreduction and overbuilding. It's what makes anterior crowns look fake, even if the shade's right on and the material choice is good. We can't have that. And so all we can worry about, the main thing we have to worry about, our half of keeping our side of the street clean, is prepping enough. Now we're pulling out this number two cord, and you can just see the lateral retraction that we have on that sulcus. That's what technicians crave. In fact, I'm starting to go clockwise around this preparation with the impression material, and you can already see how the material started to go counterclockwise because we moved the tissue laterally away from the tooth. And dentists seem to persist in this vision that you don't have to move the tissue away to be able to do that. Like, I can find a super thin impression material, or I'll jam the tooth subgingivally and get it in there. It's not gonna work, people. You have to create lateral retraction of the tissue away from the tooth to get a wide open sulcus to put your impression material into. The only way I have found to do that is either with the two core technique or a diode laser. And I'm happy to use a diode laser on the posterior, but I'm not gonna use a diode laser on the anterior. My assistant filled the double arch tray while I emptied the better part of a cartridge onto that one single prep. It's kind of a running joke I have with my assistant. Put it in the patient's mouth, close, and let him sit there for 5 minutes while that material sets. So that's the reverse preparation technique and all of its steps, ending with the impression being taken itself. And again, the key points of this that really make it different are prepping the gingival margin first and using that 801-021 burr. I would encourage you to order some of those. Maybe order the 016, the 014, the 018, whatever kind of floats your boat. We don't really need the 021 all that much. But using that to prep the gingival margins while you still have the rest of the hard tooth structure is kind of the magical part of this. And it makes prepping an almost perfect margin. Simple, straightforward, and predictable. The depth cuts are a fantastic way to ensure that your technician has enough room to do whatever they need to do. And you'll start to notice that the crowns you get back from them are properly sized. They're the same size as the teeth they were replacing. And the aesthetics on those restorations is fantastic as well. You'll also have enough thickness in case you need to do an occlusal adjustment, and you should end up with a crown that lasts for many years, if not many decades. The prep technique for a posterior tooth, all those steps are exactly the same as they were on the anterior tooth. In fact, let me suggest that you try this for the first time or two on a posterior tooth. That's how I learned to do it.